Who's a good horse? You are. That's a good one. Let's go.
Delighted to see you again, Miss Fry.
Your Highness, the plans detailing the renovations to Buckingham Palace have gone astray.
I suppose you will have to make do with the copies.
There are copies? Where?
Not so fast. First, I have a matter of some urgency. Carrying out my plan would require stealth and speed, qualities I know you possess.
Time is of the essence, Your Highness.
Then make this quick, my dear. The most influential men in Parliament remain beyond my reach. But these very men have sent for carriages to prepare for the ball tonight. Acquire an official carriage, and we shall drive the politicians to their destinations. Along the way, I will meet with them. And afterward, I shall tell you where to find the plans.
You're a shrewd negotiator.
One must be when one is so often underestimated.
Don't allow personal feelings to compromise the mission. What a mistake. Here now.
Thank you. On you go now.
Go on.
What do we have here? Stop her!
There you go. There you are. Whoa there. Slow down. Atta girl. There you are. Come on. Atta girl. Here now. That's it. Easy girl.
Will not be our cause, Miss Fryer.
Climb up, Your Highness. Where are we headed?
Belgrave Square.
Go on. Easy.
Victoria Station, please, and on the double. My son is anticipating my arrival.
Welcome, sir.
Your Highness, what a surprise.
Is life not about embracing the unexpected? I shall take but a few moments of your time. A matter of utmost importance must be discussed. When the Commonwealth seized the Punjab from my people.
It was not a seizure, but a rightful transaction.
Britain promised to protect me. By robbing me of my kingdom, Parliament acted in violation of the treaty signed with my family. Here, read it.
I was not aware.
Read. That is all I ask. You are one of the few in a position to help. I trust you and your son will enjoy the ball this evening.
He is newly returned from Delhi. I will share what we have discussed. It is most disconcerting.
That proved quite valuable.
Where to now?
St. James's Park. I noticed Mr. Green did not accompany you.
He has other things to attend to.
Ah, a pity. You two seem to get along nicely.
Well, that was a problem, you see. One must not allow our personal feelings to compromise one's mission.
That sounds like a quotation.
It is. From my father.
Ethan Fry.
You knew him?
No, unfortunately. But Mr. Green spoke of him. He sounded like an extraordinary man.
He was, Your Highness.
And your mother as well, Cecily Fry. She and your father were partners, inseparable. The only duo that came close to challenging Mr. Sparrow. And very much in love, at least from the small amount I have been told.
Cecily, I wish I could have met her.
From what Mr. Green gathered, you share much in common. Your intelligence, for one.
Father never spoke of her. What would Mr. Green like? He was only a boy when he trained with my father.
Children can be quite perceptive, Miss Fry.
Slowly. Here now. Roll there. Go on.
To Parliament, please. On the double.
Yes, sir.
Good day, sir.
Why, what are you doing here, Your Highness?
I know how busy your days have been of late. A few moments of your time is all I require.
This is all rather unorthodox, but continue.
Britain was to protect me according to the treaty my family signed. Instead, she took my land. And now I hear Britain intends to strengthen her ties to India. Perhaps it is time to return the Punjab to her people.
The Queen has supplied you with an annual income for God knows how long, and now you bite the hand that feeds you?
It is not a matter of money. I cannot stand idle and watch my homeland subjected to the yoke of an outsider's rule. My people are treated as slaves. I will die poor 1,000 times over if only...
Good day, sir.
May God bless you. Only one more remains. To the Gladstone residence.
Do you miss India?
I remember that my mother smelled of cinnamon. And when she cradled me in her arms in the summer heat, I would hold so still that she fell asleep. When I lost my kingdom, it hurt. For truly, when they took my mother away, I saw her again 2 years...
To the Zenobian Club, straight away!
Good day, Mr. Gladstone.
Mr. Singh.
You are a hard man to pin down.
I know what this is about. Your politics have worn off. Her Majesty has tired of you. So now you come begging for scraps.
You wound me deeply, sir. My people deserve freedom. I am here to fight for them.
Why did you lose the Punjab? I shall tell you, Your Highness. You were outgunned, outmaneuvered, and simply outclassed. Yes, the Sikhs deserve freedom. I hope with British help and progress, they shall achieve it.
Then why do they cry out for their king?
Britain has a duty to bring about peace. It is an enormous responsibility, and I value your guidance and advice, along with that of Parliament. But it's our burden to rule India. And much luck, Your Highness, with your lobbying. I hope my advice has done some good.
Far more than your policies thus far. But I hold out hope that you will make progress. My people are counting on it. Thank you, Miss Fry, for forwarding my cause.
Oh, you are welcome. I hope some good comes of it, despite Mr. Gladstone's vitriol.
Those of us with the largest hearts protect them the most. Your father, for instance. From what I understand, he was extraordinarily sad, broken even, after your mother's passing. That kind of pain can blind us, cause us to say outlandish things to protect the ones we love. It's time you returned this carriage and recovered those plans. They are located in Buckingham Palace. The Queen keeps them among her personal papers in the White Drawing Room. I wish you a good evening, Miss Evie Fry.
And to you, Your Highness.
Right there, miss.
Girl. There you go. Slowly now. Those coppers won't believe their eyes.
You have excellent taste.
Slow down. Easy. Go on. Easy, easy.
It's a lovely thought, my sister.
Of course he'd arrive in that.
Miss Fry?
Hand him your weapons. We must enter unarmed.
You look ravishing, Catherine. I swear I will never love you.
Not in a million years, William.
So, madam, your card.
I seem to have...
Where is my card?
Go on in, sir, madam.
Without cards.
Dear madam, I am soon to become Prime Minister. What in the blazes is our carriage doing here?
Did I hear something?
No, just the voices in your own head.
And yet, they are so much more pleasant than yours.
Charming.
Aren't I?
It's really as simple as that.
Shouldn't you be at home with her then?
That's rot.
Take a look around you.
I shall go and find the Peace of Eden.
As you wish. I'm off to meet Freddy.
The plans are located in the white drawing room, which is most likely locked. The captain of the guard will have a key. You are going to escort me. Keep your mouth closed, and this will be over before you know it.
Who are you?
That's too close. You're not allowed here.
Gentle.
What's going on?
No good. Gentle. That.
You mark my words.
No, she's not there anymore.
My arm. The lady is with me.
Much obliged.
Madam? My arm! My arm! My arm! Gentle! My arm! Gentle! My arm! My arm!
Pleasant dreams. The plans are somewhere nearby. Now for the vault. Jacob's most likely off stealing another carriage somewhere, or accidentally pushing the Queen down a flight of stairs.
There you are! I have someone I'm simply dying for you to meet. Come with me! Your Majesty, may I present Miss Evie Fry?
You are the one responsible for Mr. Gladstone's mishap.
Your Majesty, I apologize.
The cake is particularly good. Enjoy the ball.
I really must be going.
Miss Fry, may I have this dance?
Mr. Starrick, you've had your fun, but the game is over.
Listen. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Time is a wonderful thing, Miss Fry. It heals all wounds. We may make mistakes while dancing, but the mazurka ends, and then we begin again. Problem is, everyone forgets. They trip on the same mistakes over and over.
People can learn.
Can they? Isn't everyone around you repeating the same steps? But if one man could remember the dance, could know the time, then he could change things for the better.
I have had enough.
This dance is nearly over. Soon, the people will forget the generation on this terrace. The ruin you nearly wrought on London. When the music ceases, Miss Fry, your time is up. And mine begins.
Ready.
Starrick peppered the regulars with his own men and took several guards hostage. Your weapons are in there.
Look.
Right. I'll kill the imposters and rescue the captives.
It's impossible to tell the difference.
Oh, ye of little faith. Now to find the real royal guards.
Thank you.
Right. That'll be all. I'll get you out.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks, mate.
Hold still for a moment.
You have my thanks, my mate.
We're done here.
The key to the waltz is one must lead with one's right foot.
Oh, my!
Everything all right, my dear?
Do you require assistance?
I never liked balls. Here, the location of the vault. Go!
Just like that? No plan.
Time for plans. I'll catch up as soon as I'm rid of this infernal contraption.
No!
What? What are you doing?
Exploiting. I warned you, my boy. But you do not listen.
Requies Carton Pace.
Let me rectify my mistake. Let's.
Together!
London will perish without me. You flatter yourself. I would have created a paradise.
The city belongs to the people. You are but one man.
I am at the very top of the order. You were, Mr. Starrick. You were.
Shame we won't be partners anymore.
It's for the best, isn't it?
Are you gonna wear the shroud and run London?
Whatever it gives, it takes from someone else. You'd continue to age without me. You'd become like father.
A fate worse than death.
Will you wear it?
After you sorted out the boroughs, the chaos I caused, I couldn't compete.
Jacob Fry stepping back. Who's blackmailing you? Is it George?
He wouldn't dare. I've missed you.
Me too. Would it be possible to continue where we left off?
I'd love nothing more.
I'm starting to think Father didn't know everything about everything. Henry.
It's a big world out there. With London in the center.
Perhaps not the very center.
I came as soon as I could. Do not worry. I'll head back to the train. Did I jeopardize the mission?
Henry, you saved it. I think you belong in the field with me.
A carriage. Nicely done, Freddy.
Mr. Abeline, please.
Your Majesty.
Miss Fry.
You've met before?
Did I never mention?
Mr. Abeline informs me that you three are responsible for saving my life. Is this true?
It is, Your Majesty.
Evie Fry, step forward. And you?
My brother, ma'am. Jacob Fry. And this is Mr. Henry Green.
Mr. Fry? Mr. Green. Kneel. I invest you all in the Order of the Sacred Garter.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
If you are as adept as Mr. Abeline implies, I may call on you.
Sergeant Abeline tends to exaggerate, Your Majesty.
We shall meet again. And Miss Fry?
Ma'am?
Should you want it? I saved you some cake.
Father would be proud of you.
Dame Evie Fry.
Sir Jacob Fry.
Race you to the train.
You're on.
That's it. It's under the palace.
Time to go. Let's get the shroud to Dr. Grammatica immediately.
Sigma team beat us here. We're too late.
What do we do?
Killing really is the least productive way to achieve our goals. Kill them all.
Leave them underground.
Contact!
Cover me! That skinny piece of shit tried to murder me, Berg. I want him to bleed.
Us, them that told us lies of their bravery, them that preached of progress and put us in the poorhouse, them done the horrid murder on bloody stages, them that loudly crowed their humility, lords and dogs that sung in chapels on a Sunday. All quiet now, their mouths are stopped up.
Hold still, goddammit!
Only the mission matters!
Understood!
Those who fought
Sean!
Something better, those who taught by how they live, loved ones taken long before this world.
Galena, we need an exit!
Secure the vault! Our targets are righteous!
We need to go! Now!
Understood. The shroud!
Forget the bloody shroud! Stay with me, Bex. Please!
We go.
Good work in there, Initiate. In time, we will recover the shroud. And hey, we pulled a feed from our bug in Isabel's computer before they shut us out. Playing it now.
Sorry about the mess.
So, how's the shroud gonna help you create a new clone?
It's not. When the shroud is wrapped around the body, it scans it for damage and then reconstructs it on a cellular level.
You're not making a clone. You're gonna recreate a precursor from scratch.
Bingo! The Phoenix Project timetable just got accelerated big time. I'm going to call Alan Rickon and deliver the good news. It's like Christmas!
Hello? It's me? Brought the shroud as you asked, but I'm scared.
Do not fear me. You've done well.
I'm not scared of you. I'm scared for you. Anyone finds out what you've been doing.
You have played your part, my instrument. I will save you. I will save you all.
get cooped up in here.
I'm here for your benefit. Save yourself time.
What's this all about?
Come closer, Cypher. Perhaps we have met before. Perhaps not. You search for an artifact. Let me show you the truth.
What's the position of the second wave?
1 hour away, at most.
What? Don't worry, it's just the generator acting out.
Something I suspect is right something here. Is not right here. Let's work together.
Right there.
That's not very polite.
Even in these trying times, we must never forget the laws of common courtesy. Arms down. We appear to have been following the same trail, Miss Rye.
I got here first.
Indeed, you are to be commended. I fear, however, that we have not wholly rooted out evil in this vicinity.
Here's another radio.
Accompany me, if you would be so kind. Second device must be found, or new waves of Zeppelins will soon blanket the heavens.
Short on soldiers, are we?
If you could put your considerable talents to good use at Tower Bridge, you would have the thanks of a brave but beleaguered nation.
I would settle for the right to vote.
We have word of further spires near Tower Bridge.
Yeah.
Of a radio? Where is it?
I don't like the...
Why don't we just move the vehicles out of the way? This new captain's got some funny ideas.
Yeah. Mm. Where's
To be here and
getting
you
closer.
Don't me here. Just...
The radio's close to the river, but I need more than this.
What's happening here?
I just want to keep on living. There's so much more to be done. My life can't end now.
You're going too far.
Clever. The radio's in the bridge itself, North Tower. I should drop by and say hello.
Thank you. God! Someone!
It is done, sir.
Let us postpone celebrations. One of the bloody blimps has broken through. Not worry. I have a contingency plan. Heartwarming sight, Miss Fry.
Your remarkably armed boat deserves a share of recognition.
One of my experimental projects when I was Lord of the Admiralty. I haven't always been a man of shadows.
And I suppose this victory will thrust you back into the limelight.
We may have struck a blow against the enemy, but London is still riddled with German agents. Currently, there's a new group, unlike anything I've seen before. Theirs is a fanatical, almost religious fervor.
And you believe I'm the woman to flush them out?
Indeed. I dare not approach Mr. Asquith without firmer evidence, but I believe they pose an immediate threat. If you can see to this, I give you my word that once I've battled my way back into Parliament, I shall see if something can't be done about your request.
As you are aware,
a vote can be far more lethal than a bullet or a blade.
my pride and go work.
I see that.
Please don't sack me, sir.
I'll be right here if you change your mind.
Don't do it. I want no more reports that you're skulking around that area.
I don't have the stomach.
Hope you like my new office, Miss Fry. As you can see, my informants have found some promising leads. Evidence of spy activity has surfaced around the Field Hospital, St. Catherine's Docks, and the Tower of London. I needn't remind you how crucial it is that we put a stop to these infiltrators.
Miss Frank, I believe I'm quite getting the hang of this espionage business. This one should be of particular interest to you. One of the spies currently detained at the tower has been making some rather fanciful claims about a brotherhood of assassins, no less. You may want to silence him before he causes you and your associates undue trouble. Consider it my gift to you.
Huh?
I once loathed the very sight of your kind, in the same way you recoil in the presence of an arachnid. Humans were created by we who came before, the Isu. We crafted you in our image, but deprived you of our true gifts. You were bred for hard labor, and in extreme cases, war. We built great observatories to monitor you, devices to control you. We blessed you with resilience, but cursed you with ambition. And so you rebelled against us. I suppose we are to blame for the state of your species. Is it any wonder so many of these simulations revolve around violence?
To hold up the whole world. He's mad.
shouldn't be here!
I should look into that. That's it, I'm going back. Enough of this nonsense. Makes me so angry, I'm not dealing with this anymore.
When I find you, I'll string you.
Some help. I'm in trouble now.
You were a good soldier.
You'll be sorry! Ready?
shake on this.
As our people clashed, we became distracted from an impending doom. A coronal mass ejection from our angry sun. The greatest minds of our time assembled to prevent the coming disaster. Among them, forthright Minerva, proud Jupiter, beloved Aeta. We spent years locked away in the Grand Temple, attempting to find salvation. The others could only think of physical solutions. Yet I believed the only way to save us was to transform us. Inspired by the research of the great scientist Consus, I attempted to place Aita's mind into a stronger, synthetic body. I failed, and my beloved died in my arms. The others shunned me.
I think I'll take to Farland like a duck to water.
What's that you said?
That's not to say.
everything.
Yes, my boy.
Bit hard to be playing hide and seek, ain't she?
What is that strange lady doing?
Someone's gonna get quite the
stop her! Have at you!
Oh, God.
Shit! You're right.
was all in fun, sir.
That is a door nail, and good riddance.
Now
another stiff. Poor
whatever
dear.
She's doing there, I want no part.
I will feed you to me dog.
Serves you right.
Oh, blimey!
Now, are ya?
I'll cover you.
Stop that pilferer!
Is she waiting to pounce on someone?
You're looking so tough now, are ya?
The rock skull is here!
Came to nothing. In the year 2306 of the Isu era, the sun unleashed its fury on my once great civilization. I perfected the work of Consus and made it my own. I salvaged Aita's brilliant essence and inserted it into the DNA of your rebellious kind. I sent him into the unknown future to be reborn again and again. I returned to the Grand Temple. I shed my physical form and entered the Grey. But stubborn Minerva and foolish Jupiter discovered me and sealed me inside. Entombed, I waited for the day when your technology might allow my return. That wait is nearly over.
Oh.
You have excellent taste.
I don't have the stomach for it, sir.
Simple dissection.
It's
right.
After the event,
immediately.
First, you cut off the head, and then you wait for the blood.
We believe one of the spies is posing as a nurse in the nearby facilities. She has been taking blood samples into odd-looking cubes and delivering them to an unknown accomplice. Perhaps you will be able to spot them during one of these illicit rendezvous. Good luck.
I'm shifting it while I still can.
Fire on her! Business.
How on earth is he still employed?
Look, he's gonna get someone killed.
I cannot see.
Kids around here have big ears.
Miss Fry has uncovered the location of the sinister cult of spies plaguing our streets. You know your orders, lads. Follow her lead, and let us rid London of this menace.
Where am I?
Good on you!
Come, look in my way!
If you need anything else, you know where to find me.
Everything you've ever wanted, right here!
Stop mine, would you?
tide is turning in our favor. Our people in Westminster have sent word. We should stay at home.
I don't know why they keep secrets from us. He has a crazy glint in his eyes when he sees the face of God.
These documents could well be his fault.
He never suspected a thing.
Not until the blade was in his heart. The explosion went just as planned.
These documents could well win us the war.
This merits further investigation.
Got what you deserve.
Need some help?
Who are the other group? Where do they get their orders from?
Don't lose those papers, or it will be your head.
They're terrified of a few bombs. But soon we'll have hundreds.
My beloved calls to me. You will not keep this from her.
Stop, Slice, you have been...
My beloved calls to me. You will not keep me from her.
Excellent work. The ringleader is dead, as are his bizarre disciples.
Is that it, then?
Well, there is still a war on.
Then we both have our own affairs to attend to.
Know that you have done a great service to your country. Thank you.
Aita, reborn, known in your time as a sage. Thank you for discovering his fate. His pattern will be added to my own. Perhaps you believe, as other assassins before you, that it is your duty to work against me. But consider this. It was an assassin who freed me from my prison. I am no longer she who lies in wait. I am the mother of wisdom. I am the nexus of flesh and machine. I am Juno. And if the greatest assassin of your generation can see things my way, then perhaps you can too.
Are you okay? I don't know what happened. I thought I'd lost you.
Sharp knife for a sharp wit, maybe.
my newly honored friends.
Your Majesty.
We understand that with Crawford Starrick gone, a certain secret society finds itself searching for leadership. An upstart faction seeks to enter London and seize power.
Do you feel your life is in danger, ma'am?
No. Rather, I fear that the people of this grand city may suffer. I call upon you to foil this traitorous plot.
You can depend on us.
You will meet my loyal aide at the docks for instructions. Your work begins immediately.
The very best of London. Bye now.
I am Alfred Fleming. I run Her Majesty's Secret Service. First things first, we need to clear the area of anything that might alarm the enemy. Like that police carriage. Would you kindly?
Atta girl.
My agents are here, disguised as civilians. Get them into position for our ambush. A ship will soon arrive from Boston. Its cargo, dynamite. Its crew, Templar. What say you to greeting it with an ambush?
If we must, we must.
That's their leader. I want him brought to me at the station, alive.
out of here! I'll get her! I've got a clear shot at her! Whoa! Calm down!
Would you care to tell me your plans?
Go to hell!
Now.
Steric may be dead and gone, but the Templar Order will never die. We will rise again, like a phoenix from the ashes, bring the world to its knees.
Yes, well, best of luck with that.
Thank you. I'll carry on from here. My people are recovering their explosive cargo. You did fine work today. I will have a chat with our distinguished guest here to see what schemes he and his friends are brewing.
Do let me know if he says anything interesting.
Of course.
Of course it does. It should.
Your breath away from bloody death!
Mr. Fleming has attempted to force a confession from your prisoner. The miscreant refuses to talk. Will you speak to the villain and learn his secrets?
Leave it to me, Your Majesty. Must I pummel you severely about the head and shoulders? Or can we simply talk?
Might as well. The order was to load a train with explosives at Westminster. It'll detonate before reaching Southwark Station and kill everyone aboard.
You people and your damn dynamite. When does it happen?
Please! It's the next train. It should leave at any moment.
You'll never make it in time.
Separate the bomb from the other cars.
Gives a whole new twist to hiding in plain sight.
Evie, up with the sun as usual.
Our much-lamented husband adored these gardens. He called them his one safe port in the midst of the mad seas of this world. We miss him dearly. But never mind all that. To business. Our Mr. Fleming has learned from the Templar prisoner that an attack is imminent. But before we could learn more, he escaped custody. He is believed to be hiding in Westminster. We capture him for us, that we might learn his secrets.
He won't be free for long, ma'am. I promise.
Nice to see you.
Good girl.
Yeah, I would just.
You will have to rendezvous with your fellow conspirators soon enough. Easy. Here now. Too many innocents nearby. I'll snatch away the explosives before continuing the hunt.
Need some help.
What's she doing here?
here.
If we can't blow up a building, we'll just have to settle for blowing up an assassin.
There you go.
Close. I need to put an end to these upstart Templars and quickly.
I believe that should help you greatly.
What's happening there?
The final group of upstarts are making their last desperate stand. They have penetrated the Houses of Parliament and plan to detonate whatever explosives they have left. Please find Mr. Fleming, so we might put an end to this once and for all.
Thank you.
That's it.
Some sort of commotion.
It's his word against mine.
Multiple targets inside the palace, all armed and dangerous. Making matters worse, the Prime Minister has gone missing. I need you to deal with the Templars. Target one is in a nearby corridor, surrounded by civilians. He has explosives on his person. You need to take him by surprise. If he sees you, he'll detonate his bomb. In the meantime,
I must protect my sources.
Natural, ma. A gentleman does kiss and tell.
No, for the love of God,
please let me go.
Don't kill me.
Please, please, just let me live.
Baby's life. Bit out to be playing hide and seek, ain't she?
Well done. But there are still more bombers about. They must be removed quickly and quietly.
Alert! The leader of the Rooks is in the vicinity!
Steady, Prime Minister. I'll have you free in a moment.
Not another step, assassin. You've lost, don't you see? The Houses of Parliament are rigged to explode at the last stroke of 12.
There's
there's nothing you or anyone else can do to stop it now. The Houses of Parliament will be leveled. Centuries of history.
Find those bombs before they go off!
Thank you, my young friend. Now, please come with me. You and your sibling have been summoned.
You heard that!
Never again, I swear.
Approach. You have honored us with your loyalty and courage. Long may we strengthen the Empire together.
Your Majesty, we will always work to ensure the safety of the people.
But with the greatest respect, our philosophy forbids us from assisting with the expansion of the Empire. Perhaps, ma'am, you could consider putting an end to your imperialist desires.
I understand and respect your position. Bound as you are by your creed, you will indulge me one final time and receive these gifts. Goodbye, and may God bless the noble Fries.
I suppose you'll be offered any more cake.
sister.
Sometimes you exasperate me.
I hope you're having a lovely afternoon, Miss Evie. Thank you.